First of all, I think that the people should mean by being themselves and not what they can afford. We should not tell people what to do and what to buy. The same goes with education. Education is too much single-minded, in my opinion. And as well, the same goes with healthcare. Like, healthcare nowadays goes to people who can afford it. That's a big problem.
So you're saying it should be affordable for everyone?
It should be affordable for everyone. And free for everyone. There shouldn't be anything to be afforded. It should be free for everyone. However it is done. But yeah, that's important.
And which society you see where everyone is happy?
A society where everyone is happy is not everyone having the same, but everyone can live in peace with what they have. And yeah, peace is maybe the biggest thing, the biggest issue we have of all, because we're doing wars, and wars are costing a lot of money. And yeah, first of all, we should stop fighting each other, and then there's no problem with affordable, not affordable, or something, because yeah, people just live in peace, like each other, and help each other for what they are, and not for what they should be.
Society where you can work only 4 hours a day, 4 days a week, and it will be enough of money to provide your family, and all the rest time you can spend on doing some beneficial deeds in society to bring good.
It depends on the work you are doing. If you can work what's fulfilling you, then you don't mind if it's 40 hours or 4 days or 60 hours. It doesn't matter. People should be able to do what they love to do and not hopping from job to job, but doing what they love to do. Yeah, that would be the best for everyone.
Better life in society.
Yeah, first of all, the money system we are having right now, we should cancel it completely. Not money is the problem, because you need some value for something else, for a thing or something, but the money system we are having right now should be heavily discussed and probably changed a lot. Yeah.
It's good, because we now conducting conferences in the platform of our movement, Alatra Movement, and there is a conferences also about economy, and we also raised this question that it should be one platform, you know, electric platform, in the internet, when you can see all the transactions of money, where there should be like limitation of capital, so there wouldn't be people who have too much money that they can spend, you know. It should be some kind of a limit, which is enough for living you and your family, but everything else can go for education, for society. You know?
Changing the economic system. And what is your suggestion? Like having the wage cut at some point. But what happens to the rest?
Extra goes for the benefit of society. Uh-huh. For building hospitals, you know, schools, everything goes for the benefit of society, for development, infrastructure and so on.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's the same. Like, I'm doing taxes. Mm. It's my job to do taxes. And in Germany, we had a tax for rich people. Mm-hmm. Like, if you own money, not if you earn money, like it is now. If you own money, you have to give something from that away for taxes.
Good.
And probably the best thing to do, because people who have a lot of money usually have it because their family has a lot of money, and not because of developing themselves, but being born into a rich society, and that should be taxated much more, probably.
Can you tell us your opinion? How do you think, which is the limit of capital, which amount should be, in your opinion?
Of having?
Yeah, maximum.
Like, owning money? I guess owning money is zero. Zero. Because I have to earn money, and then I spend it. But owning money doesn't give me any advance in life. Like, having 100,000 euros on my account doesn't make my life any better. I need to earn money to spend it for things I need, and that's all. Having a lot of money doesn't make any sense to me. So zero is the answer for me. Sorry, but the answer is zero.
So the people all around the world found out about this constructive model faster.
How they could find out about it?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's probably people hear what their elites tell them. So, like a newspaper, or even in the internet, there are elites who are dictating the opinion. So people have to stand up, find several sources where they get their information from. For example, I think yours. So as you're telling me what your plans are and what your thoughts are, people should, and that's a good thing about YouTube. I think you're on YouTube,
yep.
Right? That's a good thing about YouTube. Spread your sources and spread your thoughts, and yeah, that's the best way to find out. We're living in an age where it's possible to find several sources. You don't only have 1, 2, 3 newspapers and your local newspaper. You have the internet, and you have the internet all over the world. It's a fact, and yeah, people should get away from what their elites tell them and go more into the internet and make their own opinion. It's not like we are telling people the financial system is rigged and maybe broken. It does not have to be the truth. Just because we think so, people have to check several sources and then they will find out themselves. And I don't think, for example, we talked about wars. And if you ask the people here, have you been to this country or to that country? And did you like it there? And then they will say, yeah. And maybe, no, I don't like Italy for any reason. But no one would say, yeah, we should bomb this country. We should bring war to this country, to none of the countries. And the elites tell us, for example, like today as we're standing here, Iran is bad. And it's not that no Iranian is a bad person. Like, we don't go there, we don't know them, okay? But they are not bad. We should not bomb people. So we lost a little bit of the ability to make our own opinion. We pick up the smartphone and go on Facebook, Instagram. The first thing we read should be true, instead of checking several sources. So yeah, that's probably it. Go out and talk to the people, and yeah.
That's what we're trying to do.
Yeah.
Thank you for such
Yeah, thank you
nice
for doing
interview.
That, and thank you for standing here.